Yes, Dominions and Dumentites, how do you fuck up a Star Wars theme park? The answer? Forget to include any Star Wars in it. That's right, my friends. Yesterday, Disney held a gala opening for Star Wars Galaxy's Edge, the new attraction at Disneyland. And I use the word attraction solely with a debilitating level of sarcasm. Present at this gala opening were Mark Hamill, Billy Dee Williams, Harrison Ford, and George Lucas. And I can tell you people, the guests visiting the park represented 95% of the actual Star Wars in the park. Because the designers of Galaxy's Edge were forbidden from including any real Star Wars in the damn attraction, and were instead directed to include only the garbage elements from the Disney sequel trilogy. That's right, guys. Those of you who are planning on visiting Galaxy's Edge needn't bother. Not if you're a Star Wars fan. Because holy bantha poodoo, this theme park is centered around a location in the Star Wars universe that we've never seen. You'd think it would be a no-brainer to make a Star Wars theme park with a cantina bar for the grown-ups, a Death Star trench run roller coaster, a Hoth adventure, a Star Wars Death Star set where you could watch Obi-Wan and Darth Vader replicate their famous duel. George Lucas crafted a veritable wonderland of limitless attractions, and all these idiots had to do was copy George Lucas and legally print money for Disney. But no. No, in this sad little outpost of outcast ideas, Disney instead opted to create a place nobody knows about, nobody cares about, where there's almost nothing to do. A Star Wars attraction where you won't see any of the original characters not featured in the sequels. So no Luke, Leia, or Han, as they were seen in the original trilogy at least. You only get the Falcon, which is the centerpiece of the whole experience and the only part of it worth a damn, because it was featured in the Abramsverse version, square antenna and all. But even this ship is perverted, polluted by a lack of Han and Chewie, and porg nests all over the ship. I kid you not. Jar Jar Abrams and Rian Johnson strike again, and the Millennium Falcon is lousy with porgs. Dear God. So no Tatooine, no sand people, no Sandcrawler, no Death Star, no Luke, no Leia, no Han, no Obi-Wan, no Hoth, just a bunch of bullshit characters we don't care about, like the Amazing Wonder Ray, Kylo Bendover, Poe, and all that kind of crap. Star Wars largely uncontaminated by anything resembling Star Wars. Well, okay, you ask. It doesn't have any Star Wars, but is it at least fun? Not according to leaked reviews by Disney Park employees themselves, who got to attend the preview and who were bitching about it online. Here is some of what they said, and I'd like to send a shout out to my friend Data Racer, who called my attention to this and tweeted out these statistics. You should follow him on Twitter, at DataRacer117. And I now quote his tweet. Early Galaxy's Edge reviews are not looking good. No original trilogy characters, sequel trilogy only. Food is awful. Blue-green milk is a vegan soy smoothie. Oh, Christ. Millennium Falcon Ride is a bad arcade game. A three-hour wait to build a $215 FX lightsaber. Oh my God. And so, here are some questions to some of these people who attended this thing. How was the food? I didn't sit down at the main restaurant, Dock 7, but most of the food I had was awful. And very likely to change, I detail that a bit more in comments. I also had the wrap, which is the main quick service food item for Galaxy's Edge, but it was pretty awful. Not to mention, out of 6 cast members, none of them could tell me what the sauce was for allergy purposes. The Millennium Falcon Ride. This is a report from Smokahontas, 1864. And Smokahontas says of the Millennium Falcon Ride, "The early reports of this experience are generally that the gunner engineer positions detract from the experience, and that it's hard to see what's going on in those positions. People have also noted that the graphic screen is sort of underwhelming and looks video gamey. People have remarked that the queue line is better than the ride itself, and that the ride is actually more of an arcade shooter. Dear God in heaven. What is the blue-green milk? Was it good? It's basically a smoothie. It's plant-based and completely vegan. It was nice. I want to try blue next. Only tried green. Holy shit, really? That's so awesome. As a Star Wars loving vegan, I was worried I would miss out on trying that. Ooh, dogmatic cat. I sense a little sarcasm. And asking about the lightsaber situation. Essentially, the process at Galaxy's Edge is this. Wait to pay, 40 minutes approximately. Wait to line up, 30 minutes approximately. Line up to wait, 35 minutes approximately. Waiting pen to build a saber, 25 minutes approximately. Go inside showroom to build a saber, 20 minutes approximately. Well, at least you can choose four starter colors, red, blue, green, and purple. That particular purple being known as disappointment purple, I assume. And here is a review posted by Saltier Than Crate that I will share with you. I went to Galaxy's Edge today and I wasn't surprised. I work at Disneyland in California and they gave each employee two free tickets for a designated day that we picked. I went earlier today and at first it's cool, but I got bored after about 15 minutes. Smuggler's Run is only fun because you walk inside the Falcon and sit in the cockpit and flip switches and buttons. The ride itself is just chasing a train stealing coaxium. Oh boy, a ride from Solo. What could be better? Fuck. And he says, it's the same thing every single time with every other time an added asteroid scene at the end where you shoot TIE fighters. Then I tried the milk and food, which was good, but the land itself just got boring real quick. I don't know why they made it an entirely new planet that no one has ever seen before, and its sequel era. Seeing the ships that look like they don't belong in Star Wars ruins the immersive experience, and the marketplace kind of looks like Maz Kanata's castle, which has many shops to buy Jedi robes and stuff, got boring fast. I'm not entirely sure if this is a continuation of those earlier comments or something else from someone other than Saltier Than Crate, but I will quote it anyway. Many other employees I've talked to that went felt the same. Even the guests we took and my 12-year-old brother said, it was all right. The only true burst of enjoyment anyone got, including myself, was first entering and then seeing the Falcon and stepping inside of it. Besides that, nothing. On top of all that, it's really small because they built it on barely any space in the back lot where we used to keep the horses and other animals. So once it opens to the public, it's going to be impossible. Jesus H. Christ. Well, my God, my God, my God. This is just looking like a disaster. I also have some other assorted comments here. Bruin Rogue, a Disney spy, says, most sabersmiths make way better ones than the sabers in Disneyland for just a bit more, so you're not missing out there. Yeah, the ride is nice, though I don't know what I would wait hours for it. It was about 20 minutes for my cast member preview. Disney blew it by enforcing the sequel trilogy only constraints, which a lot of Imagineers, many of whom are EU fans, hated. But yeah, I agree. Other than having the experience of walking inside the Falcon, there just wasn't much. And Alien Rainforest adds, oh yeah, I know, I wasn't going to buy a saber, I just wanted to look inside. But yeah, it's definitely not worth hours to wait for it. I don't know why, with a series like Star Wars, out of everything they could have done, they chose a new planet and sequel era. I waited about 15 and then 20 minutes to ride the ride again, only because I wanted to take my brother on it. But even he said it wasn't that good. LOL. Master Emotion says, thousands of people a day have touched. Talk about germs. An Alien Rainforest replies, yeah, that's another thing I don't like, LOL. I'm a bit of a germ freak and the pilot handle has probably been touched all day already before I have. I'm pretty sure they clean them each night, though we are good about that type of thing. And then Alien Rainforest adds, there's a bunch of porgs nests inside the Falcon, LOL. It broke down a couple times when I was there, actually. Oh, dear God in heaven, this thing. Needless to say, you will not find Doomcock darkening the door of this particular attraction anytime soon. It is mind-boggling, mind-boggling that Disney, if there's one thing that Disney knows so well, it is theme park design. And they are blowing it. They blew it. They killed it. I don't know what the hell they were thinking. The theme park is the backbone, from what I understand, of Disney financial concerns. They put a lot of time and effort into the parks. The parks pay off forever, so why the fuck did they do this? Why did they design a Star Wars theme park that will not appeal to Star Wars fans? God only fucking knows. And I have to say, this does not bode well for Episode 9. Disney does not understand Star Wars. That much is plain. The question is, what are we going to do about it? Without respect, we reject. Boycott Episode 9. Show them that they have to treat us with respect if they want us to open wallets in the theaters or at their theme parks. From the center of the earth, this is Dictor Van Doomcock bidding you all, my friends, stay angry.